Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Today we read a beautiful word from the Bible. That is the New Testament, 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 8. A very sensitive word, and for those who are in trouble and sorrow and sickness and who are at the terminal illness and end point of their lives, here is the word, I was crushed. Yes, the word from the Bible, 2 Corinthians 1, verse 8. Many times we have the situation in our lives. We have the situations of being happy, sorrowful, joyful, happiness. And here is the situation. I was crushed. Yes, it happens in our life when people torture us and they try to put us down. Yes, this word goes to all my beloved who are in deep, deep sorrow. Yes, you may say the same word. I was crushed. You smell delightfully fragrant. Set the gravel walk to the bed of chamomile flowers under the window. Yes, we have been trodden on, replied the chamomiles. Does that cause it? Asked the gravel walk. Here there's a beautiful picture of the garden and the flowers are speaking to each other. The beautiful flowers are speaking. Many times we have been trodden in life, but what that results out is the beautiful fragrance of life, the beautiful fragrance of love of Jesus Christ when we have been trodden and crushed. Yes, many times I see in my life, daily life, the people who suffer and who have been trodden, the widows, this message goes to them. They have been tortured. Yes, they have been trodden. Yes, they have been suffering. But do not worry. Jesus Christ loves you, my dear sister, my dear brother. You may be in sorrow and also been put down by the society and also been cast down in your family. But Jesus Christ loves you. And also, He is there with you every time. For He will never leave us nor forsake us. As we read Deuteronomy 31:6 and Joshua 1:9. And every promise that God has given us, it is true. Yes, it is yeah and amen. As we read in 2 Corinthians 1, yes, chapter, it is speaking to us. And also, never our God has failed when He has promised us the promise. So we have to read the Bible. I'll read Joshua 21:45. Every good promise that He has given us, He has done it. He has never failed. Yes, a living God never fails. He is the God of the living, not the dead. As read in Luke chapter 20, verse 38. Yes, and He is faithful to His promise. As we read in Hebrews 10:23, and also we read in Exodus 12:25, and the whole earth belongs to Him. Still, He has loved us, and He has made us the kingdom, yes, of His. Yes, He has made us the special jewels. He has chosen us, yes, and He has called us to be His. What a mighty promise. Does that cause it? Ask the gravel walk. Treading on me produces no sweetness. Yes, the gravel walk, as we walk every day on the road, that does not give a fragrance, but the flowers are speaking in the garden to the road here. Imagine this beautiful scene, that the garden is there and also we have the flowers, beautiful flowers, as we have the roses. When we crush its petal, there's fragrance, beautiful fragrance, and we love to have the beautiful smell of it, as it gives beautiful fragrance. But they have been actually trodden down, isn't it? We also in our daily life are being trodden down by people, by thoughts, by people's tongues. Yes, by their languages, by their torturous words, by their actions. But be encouraged, my dear brother and sister. Our natures are different, answered the chamomiles. Gravel walks become only the harder by being trodden upon. But the effect on our own selves is that it is pressed and bruised. When the dew is upon us, we give forth the sweet smell you now delight in. So the flowers, beautiful, pretty flowers, which is also the blessing of our God, living God, they said to the gravel walk, to the road, they said that when we have been pressed on, yes, when we have been tortured, when we have been crushed, yes, we give the beautiful fragrance, yes. And very delightfully replied the gravel walk, yes, it is true, the gravel walk, the road said to the flowers. Trials come alike to the Christians and to the man of world. The one grows bitter and harder under the experience, while the other becomes mellow and Christ-like. It is because the natures are different. We all have different natures, but let us ask Christ to come in our heart, and we will have the Christ-like nature. We will have the beautiful nature of Jesus Christ, which is full of the blessings. And as we read, the Holy Spirit has, it will be a beautiful nature that we will have, Christ-like nature, as Christ has the nature. As we read in Exodus chapter 34, it is saying the nature is of love, of compassion, yes, and also of mercy, yes, of goodness and forgiveness, and also of long-suffering and truth, yes. Oh, beautiful rose, please tell me, for I would like to know why I must crush your petals, that sweet perfume may flow. Oh, life that is clothed in beauty, perhaps like the beautiful rose, you will need to be crushed by the suffering ere you give out your best. Who knows? When we have been crushed, my dear brothers, my sisters, we will be giving our best. Yes, it happens when we suffer. We are coming up in life as we have been baked, yes, in the life process. But we are coming out to be, as a result, the best ones. Yes, full of life when we have life of Jesus Christ, when we accept Him in our heart. A life that is crushed by sorrow can feel for another's grief. When we are undergoing sorrow, we know other's grief and send out that sweet perfume of love that will bring some heart relief. Yes, when we suffer, we know what is suffering and we can console others who are in suffering. Oh, do not repine at your testing when called to pass under the rod. It is that life might the sweeter be and comes from the hand of God. Yes, Jesus Christ is there with you every second, every moment. Yes, only believe, Mark 5:36. And He is I am who I am. As we read in Exodus 3, verse 14, He knows how much we are needing of sorrow or suffering or test, and only gives to His children the things that He knoweth are best. He will give you the best. Believe in Him. Believe in Jesus Christ. Then let us rejoice when He sendeth some sorrow or hardship that tries, and be glad to be crushed as a rose leaf, that a sweeter perfume may arise. Yes, as we have been crushed in our life, as read in 2 Corinthians 1:8, we will come out to be victorious. We will come out to be giving the best fragrance of Christ. And as we have the nature of Christ, we will be glowing, yes, in our daily life. For Jesus Christ is the light of the world, as we read here in Mighty Word speaking, John 8:12. Yes, He's the light of the world. Receive Him now and be blessed. May Jesus Christ bless each of my brother and sister. Hallelujah.